Web components enable you to build great websites through the use of reusable components. But what does it take to build a web component? My name is Eiji, and today I'm going to give you an overview of Shadow DOM. Shadow DOM provides you a way to add local DOM tree inside a DOM element, with local styles and markup that are decoupled from the rest of the web page. It's just like the built-in elements created by the browser vendors. Let me show you an example. Here is a video rendered in the browser using the HTML video tag. As you can see, the video element not only provides video, it also provides its controls. Notice that we did not have to write any HTML to make those controls appear. They are just built into the video element itself. If we open up the DevTools and turn on Show User Agent Shadow DOM, we can actually look at the source for the video controls. And you see that they're actually made of HTML. This is an example of using the Shadow DOM. The nice thing about Shadow DOM is that you can actually use this feature in your own components. At the time of this recording, Shadow DOM has landed in Chrome and Opera. Firefox supports it in nightly. But support for web components is changing weekly, so be sure to check chromestatus.com for an up-to-date browser support table. To detect the availability of the Shadow DOM, check if document body create shadow root is available. For unsupported browsers, you can use platform.js, a collection of web components polyfills made available as part of the Polymer library. This will automatically detect the availability of the Shadow DOM and polyfill it if necessary. With Shadow DOM, elements can get a new kind of node associated with them called shadow root. An element that has a shadow root associated with it is called shadow host. The shadow root can be treated as an ordinary DOM element, so you can append arbitrary nodes to it. With Shadow DOM, all markups and CSS are scoped to the element. This means that CSS defined inside of the shadow root will not leak out to affect the parent document. And it also prevents the parent document from accidentally styling the contents of the shadow root. To create a shadow root, call create shadow root at any DOM element you wish to attach shadow DOM to. It will return shadow root object, which you can then append contents to. The resulting DOM structure will look something like this in DevTools. As you can see, there is a node called shadow root underneath shadow host, followed by the appended contents. You may wish to render children of your shadow host inside the shadow DOM. This is especially useful for dynamic content. For example, a name tag that is styled in the Shadow DOM but needs to pull in the user's name from an external input. You can do so by using the content element. By giving content tag a select attribute with CSS selector as a value, you can distribute host content to wherever you want. Note that select attribute can only take direct children of the host element. Because adding contents imperatively isn't that efficient, you may wish to use a more declarative approach. You can actually do so by combining template elements with Shadow DOM. In your previous episode, I explained how to work with template elements. Here is an example code I used there. I'm going to combine this with Shadow DOM. In this template, let's add content tag so that h1 tag inside shadow host will be projected here. And using JavaScript, create shadow root, then stamp out the template using import node. And the result will look something like this. So that is the very basic of the Shadow DOM. But remember, this is only a tip of the iceberg. There are tons of interesting things to learn around Shadow DOM, such as styling, event handling, and working with multiple shadow roots. The best place to learn more about Shadow DOM is on HTML5 Rocks. You can start from 101, but there are also 201 and 301, so make sure to check them all out. Thank you for watching. See you in the next episode.